your brain is not just fixed and sitting there. It's kind of floating. And so you can like get hit. And so maybe like in a car accident, you swing back. So then your brain might go back and then boom. You know, our imaging, CT, MRI, it's amazing at a lot of things. But what we know is it's not at a point now where it can pick up on the nuances of those small microcellular changes in the brain. You know, when someone hits their brain hard enough to cause bleeding or swelling, our imaging picks up on it. But by concussion, mild traumatic brain injury, by definition, you will not have positive findings on imaging. There's other injury parameters that we look at to diagnose, is this a mild traumatic brain injury? Is this a mild complicated? Is this moderate? Is it severe? There's a lot of things that we look at to classify level of brain injury. Concussion and mild traumatic brain injury is pretty elusive. Because again, it's you don't have to be knocked out to have a concussion. It's usually you get hit and you might have a couple of seconds of feeling like, you know what, I got hit. The next thing I know, I'm on the ground, but you weren't necessarily knocked out. I've seen athletes walking, talking, even continuing to play after they get hit. But if you sit down and talk to them, they're not making a whole lot of sense. And that's that post-traumatic confusion that's very common after concussion. But if that confusion resolves within 24 hours, it's consistent with a concussion. So I don't think a lot of people know that. I think it can be pretty scary. But again, not everyone's getting knocked out, so not everyone's going to the emergency room, not everyone's getting checked out.